Hey, boys, look what I got here.
Hey, where are the white women at?
What's going on, guys? I did not expect to do a fourth video today. Three's my limit. But I just watched a video from Overlord DVD. And I'm going to link that video in the description below. And the subject matter that he was speaking on resonated eerily similar to information that I had got from alleged insider late last summer. It was kind of out there, the information that I was given, but the person who was giving it to me was very nervous about when I used this information. I did write an article for ChaosCentral.com and inferred one or two things in that article. You can go check it out if you want to, that were based on the leaks that were given to me. This person had said, you know, only talk about this and this. Because this person was worried, I guess, about the people at Disney Lucasfilm that were trying to weed out informants. So I had to wait to get the okay before I could speak about anything involving this, involving those alleged leaks. Now we are months and months and months removed, you know, well into the next year. This information was given to me late last year, late summer of last year, and it had to do with some things that I'm going to have to go and look and see if I can find the notes that I took from that conversation, because some of those things that I was told did come true, but in different ways in the final cut of Rise of Skywalker that we had gotten. I do believe that there are several cuts of this movie, that it was redone, reshot several times, as has been purportedly leaked from insiders who could not be verified. Take everything I'm saying with a grain of salt too, I suppose. When I watched Doomcock's video, he was speaking about the world between worlds, and that's one of the things that was brought up by this alleged informant to me. Also brought up something about the Mortis dagger. When I see that MacGuffin, the dagger MacGuffin that was used in The Rise of Skywalker, it reminded me of that. And I was also told that Chewie would die. And, you know, we, for a moment there, you know, in the movie, you think Chewie's dead. I don't know if that was just a part of the reshoots, him not dying, or you know, if that was always the plan. I have no idea. I really am going to find these notes because I want to talk about it on the next live stream. But, regardless, what I was told was that the son of Mortis, was going to be involved. That was going to be the bad guy. Or something was going to be used from that lore. That comes from a couple episodes in the Clone Wars. Go check those out. Was it the father, the daughter, and the son of Mortis? Great episodes. Really loved those. Now, the idea of resetting Disney Star Wars by using the World Between Worlds is an excellent idea. It's an excellent idea. You can erase all the sequel trilogy garbage, put it all in its own timeline, and just act as if it never happened. Hell, give it to the Reylos. I don't care. Give it to them. And on top of that, you could have, I think, actors come back. I mean, I like Daisy Ridley. I like Adam Driver. You know, I like those actors. But the movies were terrible. So why don't you bring them back and make them the Solo twins? Give us a real Luke Skywalker. Unfortunately, Carrie Fisher's passed away, and who knows if Harrison Ford wants to do anything other than crash airplanes in California. But, you know, at least we wouldn't have our last memory of Han Solo as deadbeat dad Han. Or, you know, General Leia and Admiral freaking gender studies. At least we wouldn't have the TLJ Jake Skywalker, you know. This can be fixed. Using the World Between Worlds, it can be fixed. I've commented on it on a couple live streams back in the fall, but I never really went into it because I didn't want to expose or put any possible exposure on my informant. I am telling you from my gut, this is just my gut, take it with a grain of salt, that the information that I was given at the end of last summer, I believe, was leaks from one of the previous cuts of The Rise of Skywalker. And what Lord Doomcock has given us thus far from his independent his sources that cannot be independently verified and take with a grain of salt and all that, is connected to this. I'd be very interested to know if my former source was a part of the people that spoke to him. I'm actually hoping that isn't the case, because I think it gives more validity to it. So that's where I'm at. I'm gonna put the link to the video that I'm talking about from Overlord DVD in the description. Go check that out. Hail Lord Doomcock, thank you very much for that video. But from my perspective, from the information that I was given, the supposed leaked information that I was given from an unverified source late last summer, I really do believe that this is a possibility, that there's a faction in Disney Lucasfilm fighting to reset everything that's gone wrong and put us back on the right track, possibly using some of the EU, I would hope. So, thank you very much for watching this video. Please remember to like, comment, subscribe. Wash your hands, wash your ass. Be good to each other. Peace. Hail, my brothers and sisters in the chat. Hail the Phantom Menace. It is the Phantom Menace Historian. Your Phantom Menace Historian, born in the chats with my brothers and sisters, letting you know that the Phantom Menace Volume 1 of Phantom Betrayed is back in demand. You can pick up this first edition book on Indiegogo for a limited time. Here's a comment from someone well-respected in our community, Shellback, commenting on the importance of the Phantom Menace Volume 1.
Get on Indiegogo and order a copy of that damn book, or you're an effing retard, okay? That's, yeah.
Pick up your copy today.